Hi, I'm Vikram, and welcome back to A Roll of Film. In this episode of Shooting With, I will review some shots I took with the Yashica Mat 124G, loaded up with the Kodak Portra 400. Now, these photographs were taken in Hampi, and I think I mentioned previously that I was going to make a trip to Hampi, and I did manage to do that. It was a three-night trip, and to say that the trip was eventful is putting it mildly. We left Bangalore early in the morning, around 6:37, and we reached Hampi by lunchtime. And after freshening up and settling down in our rooms, we left for the ruins. Now, the day we arrived, it was a nice sunny day. We had some beautiful light, and we went and to the Saraswati Temple, and we went to what is known as the Royal Center, and managed to get some very nice shots. And then suddenly the skies opened up, and for the next 2 days we were totally washed out. I mean, it was just, they just rained totally. I mean, we were just impossible to take even one single exposure. On top of that, suddenly the government came out with these new rules in which they stopped photography almost altogether. They said no video, they said no what they consider called high definition photography. What they mean by that, I really have no idea. But guess what? They forgot one thing, and that is, you guessed it, film, analog photography. Never crossed their mind that anybody would actually shoot film in this day and age. So I guess we were lucky. We were the only people legally allowed to photograph in those days. Fortunately, for the others, like all government policies, it took some time for it to percolate down to the grassroots, by which time we had left. Anyway, so the first day we had some good light, and as is usual, the day we left, again, it was nice, bright and sunny. So we checked out from the hotel after breakfast, and we decided to take a quick round of the ruins once again, so that we could actually, the real reason I wanted to go was to complete that roll of film. I had taken about 5 or 6 exposures the first day, and I wanted to just finish, take another 6 exposures and finish that roll, that 120 film roll of of 12 exposures. It was so bad. Now, if you think that was the end of it, that was it. Unfortunately, no, things just got worse. I came back to Bangalore and submitted the film to the lab, and after about 10-15 days, the lab sent me the prints, sent me the scans, and they were all over the place. The studio I go to is extremely reliable. I don't know what happened this time, but the colors are all haywire. I mean, blue tint all over the place. Really didn't know what to do. So after a couple of days, I went back to them, showed them the scans, showed them the negative. I was afraid that maybe I had made some mistakes, but the negatives were fine, absolutely fine. So we did a rescan, which took another 10-15 days, and then finally I got my photographs. But after all that, I'm pretty happy with the way they turned out. So all well that ends well. So let's have a look at the images. So this is the first one. The Saraswati Temple. Now, like I said, I used Portra 400, and since it was 400 ISO, I used a shutter speed of 500. That is the nearest shutter speed to the ISO as per the Sunny 16 rule, and I follow the Sunny 16 rule. And I consistently, or in most cases, overexposed by one stop. So this is the first image. This is the Saraswati Temple, typical Hampi landscape, taken at f11, taken in the afternoon around 3:34, nice bright sunlight, f11. I think it came out pretty well. The bottom layer, this is actually made of granite, while the top is made out of brick. This is typical Hampi architecture. And generally, when you take a photograph like this, either the granite gets blown out or the top brick part goes dark. So by using an f11 exposure, I managed to get both, managed to achieve a bit of a balance between both. So neither is this granite part too blown out. You can still see enough detail, and the top brick structure is perfect. Oops. The second image is here. This is known as the Mahanavi Dibba, or it's kind of a platform from which the king would inspect his troops. And this too is got built in two types of stones. You have the darker stone and you have the lighter granite. It's full of carvings. This again was taken just immediately after I took the photograph of the Sarasvati temple. Maybe say 20 minutes, half an hour. This thing again at F11. Again, I think I managed to get detail in both the dark stone as well as the light stone. Now this is a watchtower, abandoned watchtower in what is known as the nobleman's quarters. This is one of my favorite places in Hampi because very few people actually go here. It's in one quiet corner, and again F11, nice late evening, soft light, and pretty happy with this shot. And then this is the Lotus Mahal, the famous Lotus Mahal. This is a famous landmark in Hampi, and we generally get a lot of tourist traffic here. This also is sort of a pleasure palace for the Rayas, the kings, the emperors of Hampi. And again, this is taken about half an hour. This is about around say 5:15, 5:30 in the evening, half an hour before sunset. Again, I took two shots, two different angles. I think both came out perfectly, beautiful. I love the colors here, subtle colors, the blues in the sky, and not too much of saturation. The Portra 400 really gives me some really, really beautiful colors. So this is the last shot I managed to get on the day of my arrival. The next 2 days were, as I said, washed out. Finally, on the last day when we left, we managed to get a few shots. Now this is the Virupaksha temple, the main temple in Hampi. Actually, this was taken in one of the days when it was overcast. The sun came out for about half an hour, and I managed to take this shot. This is also at F11. This dome is sort of painted white or cream, so it's a bit difficult taking the shot in the sense that it tends to get blown out. And I took this at F11, and on hindsight, I think F16 might have been a better bet. This is the gate, one of the gates of another famous temple, the Vijaya Vitala temple. This again was taken one of the overcast days when the sun came out for about 10-15 minutes. I just quickly grabbed the shot, taken at F11. I think this came out beautifully. Again, you have the difference in color between the top brick area and the granite here, but it came out pretty well. Again, the colors are very subtle, nice saturation, beautiful blues. Now this was taken on the day of departure, immediately after breakfast, around 10 o'clock in the morning. Not the best of times to shoot in Hampi. Extremely hot and harsh sunlight, taken at F11. On hindsight, again, I think F16 would have been a better bet. Could have got a little more detail in these walls and among the stones. This is again on that day. This is the Hazara Rama temple. It's a famous temple in Hampi. I have taken this shot before from the same angle using black and white. And here again, I went with the F16. Unfortunately, I didn't get the look I was after. I wanted the dark shadows to be much darker. I didn't want much detail in the shadows. So in hindsight, I think I should have gone for F22. So I guess everything is a learning process. Again, this was about half an hour after the previous shot, around 10:30, I guess. Again, not the best of times to shoot. Light was very harsh, but I wanted to achieve a certain effect, which I was unable to do. So I think I overexposed a bit too much. 22 would have been a better bet. This is a part of the Hazarama temple. Slightly backlit shot, but I think it came out pretty okay. And this is the Queen's Bath, another famous landmark taken inside. Again, as you can see, extremely harsh light. taken at F11. I think I should have gone for F16, slightly overexposed, but still a usable print. So I managed to take 11 photographs. There was one left in the roll, and on the way back, I came across this factory. Thought it made a good shot, but again, it was overcast and horrible light. But I just wanted to finish that roll. So I just took the shot. I think I took it at F4. Again, not very good. I mean, the light was bad. I mean, nothing really worked in the shot. So these are the joys of shooting with film. You never know what's going to happen. And but then all wells that ends well. And I'm looking forward to using the Yashica Mad. I think I'm going to make this my go-to camera for this year. And I have just completed a roll of black and white in Shooting Street in Bangalore, and I just dropped it off at the lab and waiting for the results to come. And once they come, I'll share it with you. So till then, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, please like, share and comment. And see you soon with the black and white shots of Bangalore. Thank you.